virtually everything I share on my YouTube site, particularly these video logs, are gifts that first my superconscious, my heart has gifted to me, and very rapidly I share. And with most of those, almost all, I have some inkling when they come to me of why they came, why my brain had been working on them. This one, I don't recall what the immediate trigger was. But it's an issue that for much of the last 10, 12, 13 years has occasionally been on my mind, and I think been on the mind of others that were kind of watching me, maybe closely or from a distance. Such issues as, now start, you know, why aren't you devoting time to fundraising? Why aren't you, devoting time to promoting that you're on hunger strike? I'm sorry, friend. I'm working on something right here.
Huh?
Mm-hmm. Why aren't you advertising? Why aren't you doing PR to expose people to your work? Why aren't you working on housing for yourself? And it's the times I've asked myself that are not because I've doubted that I was doing the right thing. My superconscious, what wisdom is within me, I'd question and it would quickly say, no, this is right. But it's only in the last couple of days that I've had clarity, and actually in the last couple of minutes that the clarity really slammed in. It's a duty of the unviolent warrior, of the peacemaker. It's a duty to do one's own job and to scrupulously avoid doing the job of others, that others should be doing by rights, by morality, by conscience, in support or coordination or cooperation with the efforts of that peacemaker. Tragically, this will seem like an obscure reference to many of you, but it's a profoundly important one. It so happens I devoted most of my adult life to helping manufacturers succeed and in many cases avoid being destroyed by foreign competitors, particularly Japan. And certainly back in the 80s and also in the 90s, the most successful manufacturers, but let's go to the 80s, were in Japan and in the process of annihilating the Detroit automotives. I worked in Detroit for a while. The poorly thought out, comfortable, intuitive thinking of the Detroit automotives was, well, we should try and be everything to all customers, any colors they want, any options they want, any variations they want. And in our manufacturing process, what we should expect of our workers is to basically say yes to every demand and to overcome any obstacle and any difficulty, and to do that while making it really transparent to the corporation and to the other workers. And Japan was eating the lunch of Detroit because they had the opposite view. No. In the real world, there are limits to what any individual can do. There's no magic. There are limits to what any corporation can do by way of providing products to their client. So what they owe to their client is the honest facing of what those limitations are and basically saying to the world, okay, here's what we can provide to you, but we'll provide it really, really, really well at the best possible price and at the best conceivable quality. What we say we can do, we will do, and we will do to a high level of quality. Behind the scenes in the manufacturing process, they also took this ferociously to heart in ways that, almost to their demise, Detroit couldn't imagine. Rather than the automotive companies in Japan demanding of their workers that they just get the job done, no matter what it took, in whatever way, whatever extra measures, just getting it done and hiding whatever problems by way of mistaken notion of service, hiding it from co-workers, hiding it from management, just solve the problem, get it done. No, Japan took exactly the opposite approach. If there's a problem on the assembly line, we want to know about that immediately. Stop the assembly line. Stop it. This was anathema in Detroit. Inconceivable. Japan said, stop it. Figure out what it is and solve it and don't let it happen again. Don't provide the mistaken notion of serving your fellow workers by, you know, just sweeping under the rug that this bolt wasn't properly installed by the previous worker. That the bolts frequently don't fit right, and so you do a little machining to make sure that the bolts do fit right on many of the bolts. No, no, stop it. Stop it. Don't do the work of the upstream people. Don't do the work of the downstream people. The point isn't to make others in trouble, but let the failures, let the voids be apparent, because far and away the most powerful motivator, the most powerful communicator between people is visual. Let the problem be seen. Don't paper it over. Well, sorry for those of you that think this is obscure to my reference of, well, start, you know, why don't you promote? Why don't you advertise? Why don't you do press? Why don't you do fundraising in addition to what you already do? My nervous system is so much smarter than I am, but eventually it says, okay, start. Here's what it is. Here's why. This is why. I do my job as best I can. I can't do the job of others except by compromising what I'm called to do. And in making the attempt, I paper over voids that others should probably be filling. Oh my gosh, start, you egotistical whatever. No, I don't think so. I don't think so. I'm not telling others what to do. But I think conscience says that probably Start should be receiving more support than he is. But my goodness, friends, one of the greatest gifts that's been given me is I don't worry about other people's business. I don't worry about whether other people are doing their business, including whether or not they should be coordinating with or supporting Start's work. For me to be aware of what I'm sharing here now is not the same as, gee, every day, every hour, every month, every week, Start thinks about why aren't people doing this to support his work or otherwise. No. It's not my job, but it is my job to be aware of dynamics like I'm sharing here. It is my job to be accountable when I behave in a certain way, when I don't follow people's advice. Start, you should be doing fundraising. Start, you should be doing PR. Start, you should be telling people you're on hunger strike, whatever. It is my job to be accountable appropriately to such well-intended comments and ultimately to either understand, Start, this is why you're not heeding their advice, or Start, this is why you should. And mercifully, really within the last hour, my nervous system has finally revealed to me, Start, this is why you should steadfastly do your job and refuse to do the job that others should be stepping in on. There we go. That was a particularly nice one for me to receive. It's been years that I've stubbornly been adhering to the right practice, but only today received the clarity as to why it was correct.